Did you know that almost one third of all people file for Social Security almost as soon as they can? And for most of us, that's age 62. But just because a third of Americans do that doesn't make it right for you. So let's go for a walk and I'll talk to you about the seven main reasons I think it makes sense for you to think about filing for Social Security at age 62. And the first of, there's three main categories that these seven areas fall into. And the first of these categories used to be like 90% of the whole decision. Like a decade ago, most financial advisors, even Social Security's website really focused on this, which is what's called a break-even analysis, which would basically be, you'd go on the Social Security website. You can still do this. It's not as prominently displayed anymore. I'll leave a link if you're interested in doing this. But you go on Social Security's website and you say, hey, this is what it looks like if I retire now at 62. And this is, and Social Security will tell you, you know, assuming you live to this age, this is where the break even will be. Again, do this calculation for yourself. But for most people, that break even point, 62 versus full retirement age, for most people, that break even point was about age 77. And the difference between full retirement age in age 70, which is when you stop getting that 8% increase every year that you wait to take Social Security. For most people, the difference between full retirement age and waiting till 70 to take Social Security, for most people, that break-even point was about age 82. And that used to be 90% of the argument, but you know, it's a lot more complex than that. And the two other main factors that these 7 points are going to come out of, the first ones being the break-even analysis, but the other six, the other points with that is, who else might you taking Social Security open up benefits for? And the most common one would be a spousal benefit. So a spouse can choose to take their own Social Security, or they can choose to take half of their spouse's Social Security. But they can only do that if their spouse has filed and is taking Social Security. Now, I should say this is not financial advice. These videos are to give you things to think about and to research on your own. I don't know your situation, so I can't give you financial advice, but I can give you some things to think about and to research on your own. Okay, let's go back to this spousal benefit. So if you're the high earner and half of your Social Security benefit is way higher than what your spouse's would be on their own, then it might make sense for you to file as soon as you can, particularly if your spouse is the same age as you or older, and they could get that higher benefit from you, but they've got to wait until you start taking Social Security. So that's one way to look at it. Another way to look at it is the converse of that. If you're the spouse that has made less money and your spouse has made more money, then your decisions today are not going to lock you in for the rest of your life. Let's say you're 5 years older than your spouse, just to give numbers out here, just to give a little bit of specificity to this. So you can take Social Security now, but your spouse cannot. Well, eventually, if you know that you're going to take half of your spouse's benefit because it's quite a bit higher than yours, then it might make sense for you to start taking your Social Security now, because later you can switch over. So that's the second category is whose benefits does your taking Social Security or the opposite of that kick in by either you taking Social Security early now, or you take Social Security now and then change later to half of what your spouse gets. So hopefully that makes sense. Okay, the third main category, which is where most of these points are going to come from, is your individual situation, right? What makes sense for you? And one of those first categories would be if you already have a pension, let's say from a state or the federal government or the military, if you have a pension that is already indexed for inflation, in some ways that is, in some ways, Social Security is longevity insurance. If you end up living to 100, right, that's a long time for your investments to provide income for you. So Social Security, because it's indexed currently, the way it's currently set up, it's indexed for inflation. I think that's going to stay in place, but I don't know. It could change. But if you already have a pension that's indexed for inflation, that takes care of some of your longevity needs, right? If you do live to be 100, boy, that pension that continues to increase every year with inflation is going to be very, very valuable for you as you get into your late 80s, your 90s, and who knows, maybe even your hundreds. So if you have something like that, then having Social Security as your longevity insurance is still important, but it's less important than somebody, most of us, frankly, that don't have a pension that's adjusted for inflation. So that's an individual situation that's really important. Another one is if you want to preserve your investments and you don't want to start taking your investment money, taking funds from your investments, then taking Social Security early might allow you to not have to tap into your investments early. If you're going to do a Roth conversion, depending on your tax situation, some of your Social Security could end up being taxable. And if that's kicking you into a higher tax bracket, it can make it more difficult for you to do, more expensive. I shouldn't say difficult. It's just more expensive to do Roth conversions. So that's something for you to look into. Okay. Another one is, you know, unfortunately, if you have poor health and or you have a family history of not having longevity, of having a short lifespan, of relatives dying in their 60s, let's say, then, you know, if that's your situation and your doctor has told you that, you know, your blood pressure is high, you've got high cholesterol, maybe you've got heart disease, whatever that is, if you don't think you're going to live into your 70s, then taking Social Security sooner, you know, you really want to do that analysis and think about it more seriously if that's your situation, right? So if you have poor health, that can be a reason to take Social Security early. Related to that, but maybe not, is if you just can't work anymore. If you have a job that's physically demanding and maybe you're, let's say you're a carpenter and, you know, there's only so many houses that you can build and so much manual labor that you can do. So if your body just can't work anymore and you have to retire early because your body's getting tired, then having that extra income come in can really be extremely helpful to family. So if you have that, or conversely, if you know you've been in your job for a while and your company's come to you and said, you know, it's time for you to think about retiring, and you're not alone if that's your situation. 2/3 of people report not working, you know, having to retire before age 65 because either their health gave out on them or something happened at work that caused them to retire early. So it wasn't voluntary on their standpoint. So that can be hard. I hope that's not your case. But if it is, that would be a factor to think about Social Security early. Okay. Number five is one that I think is super important. And that is, you know, you just want to enjoy your money while you're in the youth of your senior years. You're going to have more utility. You're going to have more things that you can do that are going to be fun when you're 62 than when you're 70, when you're 80, or when you're 90. And so some people look at it and say, yes, I know the amount, my monthly amount is going to be less, but I think I'm going to get a lot more enjoyment by taking that money now. And I think that's a really good reason to think about taking Social Security at 62. But you want to make a good decision. And in order to make a good decision, you have to think about the trade-offs between taking Social Security at 62 and taking Social Security at 70. And to fully think through that, you want to watch this video here that talks about the benefits of waiting as long as you can, of waiting until 70 to take Social Security.